From their spinning teacups, where they ponder the difference between Tweedledum and Tweedledee, it's the Mr. Frank's Wild Ride Show. We're gonna have great Disney talk, music, mayhem, and mirth.
Ah, gosh! Oh, boy!
Yep. What's mirth?
So let's round up our hosts as we start up our engines for Mr. Frank's Wild Ride Show.
'Cause Mr. Frank's Wild Ride Show is the wildest ride in the wilderness.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to Mr. Frank's Wild Ride. This is Mr. Frank, as I'm known on this show, or Disney Frank. This is their other lands and in the online world. And I have with me my Disney big sis, Heather. Hi, Heather.
Hi, Frank. Hey, everybody.
And I have my good buddy, Chris underscore Topher. Hi, Chris.
Hey, everybody. How's it going? How you doing?
Chris is at somebody else's house. That's why we also have an additional female in the background. So anybody watching?
My friend Bree is allowing me to use her computer tonight. So.
Hi, Bree. Thank you.
Welcome.
But I have these really cool vinyl missions along with me. One from the Great Movie Ride and one from my attraction.
Your attraction, which is?
Kilimanjaro Safaris. Yeah. At Safaris, we go wild.
That's right. When you go on Kilimanjaro Safaris, you must ask for your driver, Chris. Now, Chris, when you're driving in Kilimanjaro, though, you're Chris from Australia?
No, I'm actually Chris from Chris. Again,
so. You're Chris from Chris?
I rarely use the Australian accent anymore when I do the safari.
So, okay, so you're a pure American when you're driving now African safari.
And I get the question from people all the time, well, you don't sound like from Australia. Yeah, well, you know, I moved here when I was really young. But I'm actually...
And then do you introduce him to your cousin Pinocchio?
Yeah. Do you?
You see this face that I'm making right now?
It looks pretty red.
Okay, seriously. Seriously, I love this setup, and I'm definitely going to have to get a Mac because it's much better than my laptop.
Macs are the best, especially for stuff like this.
Yes.
Yes, apparently they'll say Heather, Disney Big Sis, but they won't say Frank. They won't say my name.
And they won't say my name, but you know what? I'm memorable anyway.
That's true. That's true. And here we are for, I believe this is episode, I want to say 42. I want to make sure I don't have that wrong.
That's what my screen says, Frank, is 42.
My screen says 42, too.
Okay, so we are in episode 42 of Mr. Frank's Wild Ride, and we want to start out by, well, let's talk about what has been happening lately. We had some interesting meetups happening out there, and Heather, you were in Disneyland, but you were more specifically into the new park, and tell us what, of course, it's still called the same, but it is almost a brand new park altogether. What is that?
It is pretty much a brand new park. It's just amazing. In fact, it was so much fun to be standing in there and feeling like a tourist again. It was kind of weird because things are still where they kind of used to be, but it's totally different. It's just an amazing, amazing park. And I'm so glad that we did the D23 preview event where we went out 2 weeks ago and we were able to do Cars Land and a special World of Color for D23 people. I was so glad that we did because Cars Land wasn't that full. You could still see everything, do everything. And it was just such a wonderful experience. It's just amazing. And the pictures that you see online of Cars Land don't even do it justice. I mean, it's amazing, all the detail, everything. There's only three attractions in there, but the whole place is an attraction unto itself. Just standing in line at the cones waiting to get some of the cone food is an adventure. Or going into some of the shops, just walking down the street. It's absolutely mind-blowing. I would love to have been there the night that they had for the preview for Pixar, just to hear what they had to say about it. Because just me as a fan walking Route 66 and walking in there around the attractions was just amazing. And then the Radiator Springs Racers, I don't know if I would think it was worth it if I waited 5 hours to ride on it. The longest I waited was, 5 hours.
5 hours? You saw my
5 hours.
For those that can't see my face.
Yeah, people have waited 5 hours for the attraction. The longest we waited was 45 minutes. They do have single rider, and that's how we've experienced it. I've yet to experience it as a family. But
there's video of the wait sign saying 240-minute wait instead.
Yes. Yes, yes, actually, yes, and I have personally seen it say that. So, in the mornings, the lineup for the racers just to try and get a fast pass for the day was pretty intense. It stretched, for those of you who've been to the park, it stretches from Bugs Land all the way back down Buena Vista Street and all the way through Hollywood Land and around the corner to the Hollywood Tower of Terror. Wow. And I don't believe that everybody that got in line first was able to get a fast pass for them all to be gone for the whole day. So it's something that if that's important for you to do on your trip, if you're only going to get there this summer and it doesn't look like you're going to get back to the park anytime soon, just decide if that's something that you want to do. And if it is, that's just plan that to be your day. Just make your day about it. That way you're not freaking out or stressing out about anything else that you want to do. Just make it your day. We did that when Nemo opened. We planned that was all we were going to do, and we waited in line for 6 hours to do Nemo.
Questions.
But they do have people, and it's so neat. So, like, they have from the 50s, like a car hop, where they actually have the thing strapped around them, and then they have, like, this tray, and then they're walking around selling popcorn, sodas, ice creams, everything throughout the line. So if you're in that line for 5 hours, other than them wheeling a porta potty by for you, you can stay hydrated, you can have a snack. There's really nothing to worry about, because if you didn't get a pop or a water the first time they walked by, someone will be by in another few minutes with another offering for you. But it's amazing. And like I said, all the pictures and videos that you see, it still doesn't do it justice. You're standing there waiting to ride Mater's Junkyard Jamboree, and you look down and the stanchions that they have with the chains and everything, or the ropes that they have, the tops of them are like little radiator caps, and it's amazing. And then Buena Vista Street, it really is like stepping back in time. You really do feel like it's the 20s and 30s, the way they've done the architecture. I'm originally from Southern California, so it reminded me a lot of like some of the older things down there, but it was just amazing. It's phenomenal. And we ate at the Carthay Circle for lunch.
How was it?
It was the best.
So did they have options for you there?
Well, that would be my only criticism that I would have of the restaurant, was that limited options for me. I've decided I was just going to order an Angus burger because the burgers looked really good as they were going by, but they do not at this time have any gluten-free bread. So there wouldn't have been a way for me to have had a hamburger. I would have had to have, done the, been like a ground patty there. And then also there weren't any dessert options for me. The only thing that they could have done was some mixed berries, because even their ice cream, he said, has a wheat stabilizer in it.
Wow. Well, you would be happy to know this, that the new Be Our Guest restaurant is going to have tons of gluten-free.
Yay! And, for those of you in the chat room, for me, it's not a choice. This is not like a lifestyle choice. This is, if I eat it, I'm in the hospital, in the emergency room, and it's not good.
You have so.
Oh, phenomenal. Absolutely. Phenomenal! So, yeah, but, I mean, it was just, you guys, I can't even begin to describe it. Frank, I wish there was a way I could get you out here so you could see it with the red car going down the street. And I actually bought a pair of these little beauties.
Oh, my gosh.
I got a pair of these. These were phenomenal, and when we get to the Disney news segment, I will I'll talk about Glow with the Show because we did that too. But the Matterhorn's reopened. I didn't really notice any difference other than the cars are different. My favorite side to ride is still when you're looking at the loading area. I still prefer to ride on the right side. That to me has the smoother and the more fun ride, and I missed 2 days in the park due to have the stupid stomach flu. So I can't wait to go back. Yeah. I mean, every time you leave the park, you're like, oh, I can't wait to go back. Now I can't wait to go back.
What's the badge say on that hat?
What's the badge say on the hat?
I can't see what it says. What does it say, guys? It says, I see the connections.
It says, I think it says conductor.
Yeah, that's actually.
It says red car. It's the red car. They're red. It says red car trolley conductor.
That's
comfort,
actually,
speed, and safety.
It's very similar to what the train conductors on Main Street wear, the hat that they wear without the ears.
Yes. So and as I was driving home yesterday, I was wearing these as I was driving home, and it was kind of fun because sometimes people were laughing when they saw them. Other people, I got the thumbs up and some honks, and then I got, you know, then of course there are the pickle suckers that were like, some of those.
I love that pickle sucker.
Yeah, some of them were pickle suckers, but this was my souvenir that I got at Cars Land.
Ooh, look, Chris.
It's a
traffic cone. It's a mug.
That is a giant drink container.
It's a thirsty 2 ounce drink container. I haven't taken it to work yet. It's going to work with me, but it doesn't fit like in the cup holder.
Right.
So I'm gonna have to figure out how to get it there.
Here's the thing, Heather. If you have any car trouble, you can just stick that in front or behind your car, and then you're set.
That's true. That's true. But no, it was just great. And I'm so glad we did the D23 preview because on the way out, I looked at my mom and I said, the last time and the next time I would ever see it this empty or with this few people is if I was working custodial out here scraping gum off the pavement, because there was hardly anybody in there. And it was just amazing. I mean, to stand there and look at the rocks at night. Yeah. It's just, you guys, there are no words. It was just, it really is like you're walking through Radiator Springs.
How do you think it's going to be in October when I go there for my birthday?
It's going to be busy because October's busy. Because not only because of Cars Land, they're also, it's going to be the Halloween time. And make sure you get the Halloween tickets for the Halloween parties.
I'm definitely, because I think I'm going to be there out there 4 or 5 days. So I think if I plan out my 4 or 5 days,
Just plan for one day to be with the racers. And if you do, just do single rider. And the thing is, for everybody, just keep this in the back of your mind, too. Two quick little notes on the new park. Uh-huh. One is if you do the single rider, they do shut the line down. But what we did is we kind of hung out because when they reopen it, it's only open for less than 5 minutes for them to add more people through the line. So don't have them, they'll say, come back in a half hour, and you come back in a half hour. They're like, it's closed, come back in 45 minutes. So we just kind of hung out, and then when they opened it, they sent us on through. And then the other thing is they now have a Starbucks in there, and there's Clarabelle's ice cream and then the Starbucks. And the Starbucks has all the Starbucks treats that you could think of that you want, plus sandwiches and baked goods and things. But you can use your Starbucks gold card in the park to pay for your drinks and continue to get your points. My mom figured that out at the last minute. My mom figured that out last day. She was so mad. She's like, I missed a whole week's worth of stars I could have gotten. So just, think about that too.
What'd you say, Chris?
I said, I only have a green card. I don't have a gold card yet. I'm not like Heather. Or Mike. My friend Mike who's done the show. And my friends.
Yeah.
Yep.
They all have gold cards. I just barely got my green card. I'm from Australia. I just barely got my green card. It's fantastic.
Oh, you're funny. But it's just, it's amazing. Can't wait to go back. And then Disneyland, just magic. There's still some things going on over there. But my best advice, if you're planning a trip out west, watch the Disney Parks blog, because they don't really have a mom's panel. They do have a person that specializes in Disneyland on the Walt Disney World Moms panel. But for most up-to-date current information, go to the Disney Parks blog. There's a lot of great information there. So I would check it out.
Well, it sounds like a lot of fun. I wish I had the money to get out there.
I wish you did too, Frank.
I'm working on something for you, Frank. I've got to text you, but I'm working on something.
Hey, can you work on something for me in November?
I'll see what I can.
Cool.
I don't want to get you too excited.
I want to see your face, though. I want to see your face, Chris. I can't see your face.
Oh, you want to see my face?
It's a Vidcast.
Let's see you.
People can see us now, Chris.
People can see us. We're not just the podcast anymore. Oh, and you know, just kind of go back to something that went on for the last month or so since we've been together. Disney had their price increase. I know everybody go, have to say that, you know, between parking, because I always get the premium, but between parking and purchases, between souvenir purchases and food, and everything else that I got my discount on last week, I totaled it up, and I saved $260, and 90 of it was parking.
There you go.
So, I mean, the pass that I buy, I think my renewal rate, because they only give us $20, whereas if you're DVC in Florida, you get like $150 off your ticket, but for me in California, it's going to be $650 to renew. So if you look at it that way, and instead of paying $15 a day for, yeah, Chris.
What?
Yeah, it's $650 to renew my pass. But if I look at it where I just save $90 in parking for those days, plus I get 15% off food, 20 off merchandise.
Now, is that just for the two parks, or is that for all six?
No, in California that is two parks only.
Okay, so let me get this straight. So the two parks is more expensive than all four?
Yes.
Than the four here?
It's about the same, because if you're a DVC member in Florida, you get $150 off your park ticket. But if you're a DVC member in California, you only get 20. So no amount of complaining is going to change it. So I'm just trying to figure out how to sock that money away so I can pay it. But luckily my whole family, thank goodness, we're all on different renewal times. Cause the worst was like the first year and we were all like to renew at the same time. It was awful. I thought I was gonna have to sell a kidney. It was terrible.
Does Disneyland have a payment plan like us here in Disney World?
For residents, yes, but since I'm not a Southern California resident, even when we used to live in Northern California, it still wouldn't have worked for me.
It's only
certain Southern California zip codes.
Okay.
You act all shocked, Chris.
I know the whole state of Florida gets a Florida discount for Florida.
It's a little different out here.
Ryan says it's still cheaper than becoming a member of Club 33.
That's true. If you can become a member. I know Club, 1901. The new Club 1901 was still accepting members, but.
This is true.
And then I think that the new pass for both parks is like 800. So my the field that I work in, their national convention is in Orlando.
What?
Chris, I want to tell you, stop acting like this.
We have a national convention, so then I was trying to figure out what to do, but I don't know. So I was just pointing out, though, that if you do purchase that pass, the discounts that I saved, I got 15% off our lunch and at the Carthay, and it was well worth the money.
Okay. So it's well worth the money, Chris. Cheer up, buddy.
If you're just going to go once, it's not worth it. I mean, if you're going to go once and you're only going to be there for 4 days, no, it would not make sense to pay that.
Right.
But if you're like us, if you go three times in a year, then it makes sense because they've also gotten rid of their 6-day hopper tickets. They now only have 5-day hopper tickets.
Do they not have 7-day?
No, 5.
See, it's interesting to me because, you know, the company, like we, with the whole company-wide, like we all have matching IDs now, you know, everyone at Disney, no matter if you're Disney Store, Walt Disney World, Disneyland. So I would think it would be more, this is my train of thought, and if I ever become an executive at Disney, I'm going to try to do something like this. But, you know, you would think
you better get on it, buddy.
Working on it. Right here, right now, I'm right here. Right now, this is where I am.
There you go.
But this is actually a really great spot to get to a lot of places in Disney.
That's right.
So I'm going, you know, I just think, you know, we're working on all the parks being the same under one thing. I would think they would want to do that for the guests, too.
I don't know. One day when I rule the world,
aka yeah, Disney I don't know.
Oh, what are the really neat things that they added to Disneyland though? From the West Coast, from the East Coast, Voices of Liberty. The Voices of Liberty are out there with Mr. Lincoln. It was wonderful. That was the last thing we saw before we had to run home with the flu. But it was just amazing. It was beautiful. It was so perfect with Mr. Lincoln. In fact, for me, I enjoy Mr. Lincoln better than the Hall of Presidents. I know that's kind of sacrilege to say sometimes, but to me, Mr. Lincoln, it's more of an intimate experience, and I end up with a patriotic and a, anyway, there's just something about Mr. Lincoln that I get that I don't get from the Hall of Presidents. I love the Hall of Presidents. I think it's great, but it's just something. And then to see the Voices of Liberty out front, and then you go in that little theater with Mr. Lincoln and they perform. It was just amazing. It was jaw-dropping, an amazing experience.
See, and this is something cool, and I'm actually going to, hopefully next time they do auditions for it, but I was actually told by a few people in entertainment that I need to audition for Voices of Liberty for here. That's actually one of the groups that I have not auditioned for yet.
Oh, you should.
I want to when they have auditions for it, but I would really, I really want to do it because I think it'd be fun. But it's just the tough thing about entertainment. It is you really once you get your foot in the door, you're in the door. But it's actually getting your foot in the door. So right. I'm working on getting my foot in the door and like doing different things. Like I'm part of the group we have Ryan's funny. Chris, Ryan goes, Chris, you have to be an American to try out. Yeah. Thanks, Ryan. But he said, you know, I just thought about doing. Yeah, I really want to do that. Because I'm trying to get my name out there as much as I can. We actually have a performance group called Encore that I'm part of. We have a is coming up. Are you coming to that, Keith? Okay, the one year I'm in it, you're not going to come. Yeah, I see how it is. Talk to Steamboat Willie. No, but so I'm trying, because a lot of the people that are in entertainment or are managers in entertainment do Encore. So, you know, I know a lot of them from when I would actually work on it. I know them from when I used to audition for American Idol Experience all the time, so I know a few of them. So, you know, a lot of their recommendations, you know, you really need to try out for Voices of Liberty. So I'm going to when I have
very
time.
Cool.
Because my life's about to get crazy the next couple months.
Yeah.
So we'll talk about that in my view of the world. But Heather, your trip sounded awesome. Besides, you know, the last couple of days.
Yeah, well, and we kind of have to, you know, it stunk that we were sick. But we were still together, and that was the whole point of why we go on these girls' trips. And then plus, we were spoiled. We did have a wonderful short trip for the D23 event, and then we went back 2 weeks later. So I can't, you know, I mean, yeah, it sucks to be sick, but, you know, complaining isn't going to change it, right?
Exactly. But you were all together, and that's the important thing.
We were all together. Yeah, that's right.
Okay, well let's see if we can't share the wrong
No, I do not want longer lashes, thanks though.
You don't want that?
Oh, and guys, a big announcement. Yesterday was our good friend Frank's birthday.
Frank, happy birthday.
So, really quick before we do anything else, I'm going to sing for
this him. This is your birthday song. It is a very long.
Hey. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Frank, Francis, and Franklin. Happy birthday to you.
I froze for some reason.
Yay!
No, he had multiple personalities in there.
There you go.
That's what I call him Frank when I'm upset with him. I call him Francis.
Francis.
Yes.
Otherwise, I call him Franklin.
Let's see if I can get the right picture up here since we're at the end of.
Hey, Frank, can I email you some pictures too that you can put on the website from the trip?
Sure.
I think we should wait for someone to, you know, Heather and her Disney trip. She might talk about wanting long bushes and we'll ask her to use that too.
I don't understand a word you just said.
I was teasing you. I said, hey, we might wait for Heather to talk about wanting longer lashes and what you can use, what mascara you can use at Disney.
Still didn't understand it.
Am I okay?
You sounded like you're on Skype.
Take a breath. I'm gonna read this for the show. This is a Disney. This is written by me. This is from Disney Amanda 3. Disney is there through life's challenges. Disney is there, supplying a smile, warm hug, reminding, share the magic within joyfully, healing what ails. That is Disney is there.
Aw, that's pretty. Aww. Frank.
Thank you. And we'll be right back, and we'll do some Disney news, and we'll let Heather tell us, catch us up on what's happening in her neck of the woods. Okay, so...
Oh, my neck of the woods. I've got Disney news.
Yes, your news comes in yours, which is in the last segment of the show.
Did we change that?
No, you've always been the last segment of the show.
No, but I've always done Disney news along with Heather.
Yes, you both are doing news, and then you do your segment of on the third.
I got confused. I'm sorry. I'll be right back. Give me 2 seconds.
Okay. News is always in the middle with Heather and Chris.
You get the news, the travel tip, and then Chris's news, and then his view of the world. Is he new? I'm like, is this crazy twin?
Yeah, that's something.
This, I loved wearing my hat yesterday driving home. It was hilarious watching people's reactions.
I would like to see
it's huge, though. I mean, it's big. I can put both hands in between the front of the hat and my head.
Yep.
So, I didn't wear it in the park because it would have flown off. No.
Well, Chris is gone.
The costumes over at DCA are just amazing. It's like, it was so funny. I'm running around taking pictures like I'd never been there before. It was total tourist. Hey, keep your eye out for these purses. They're doing a whole series of these bags. They're Mary Blair bags, and this was the one with the mermaids from Small World. It's a whole Small World series.
Oh.
It's a world of laughter, a world of cheer.
There you go.
So it was going to take you too long to drive home from wherever you were, so you stopped at a friend's house who let you use their laptop for this, huh?
Whenever y'all are
always a friend.
She's awesome. She's a good friend. Hey now.
Denny,
yeah, 9-1.
Denny saw your cap and she says, "Hi, Ireland."
Hello there, criminal the saints preserve us.
All right. Something preserve me. Are we ready to go again?
I don't know. Are we ready, Chris?
Yes, I'm ready whenever you all are. Oh, yeah. Oh, I heard, is she there? Is she around? I want to say hi to her. I miss her.
Oh, yeah, and she's sticking her head in because she needs to stick your head in.
Hey, I want to talk to you. Get over here.
Just say hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. I miss talking to you.
I miss you too. I need to get over to Florida so I can see you.
Yeah, you do. She sounds so grown up, Heather.
Yeah, rub it in.
She's 15 or 16?
17.
I'm 16.
Oh, almost 17.
There you go. I knew she had her driver's license.
Yeah.
No, not yet.
Not yet. Insurance reasons?
Yeah, not yet.
Soon, right?
Not yet. Maybe. We're going to do the driving school through one of the school districts.
Because
actually, if you complete that course, you don't have to go to the MVD and take a driver's test with them.
That's awesome.
Yeah, as long as you don't kill a kid, you'll be fine.
She won't. It's Hannah. She's responsible. She's actually one of the
few. Exactly. Thank you, Chris.
She's actually one of the
Your day is coming, buddy, Frank. Yeah. You guys just keep, you know.
That one right there is probably one of the few teenagers I will ever worry about.
My girl's just turned 10. I got a few years left on her.
Look at her.
Oh, it won't be that long. Trust me. It just seems like yesterday she turned 12.
I know.
I remember when she turned 14 and she went to her first dance, and I was like, oh, what?
Yeah, well, she's been on her first date, too.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is his name?
We're not going to disclose that.
What's his name again?
You and I are going to talk a little later.
No. You'll have to talk a little later.
Yeah, we'll have to talk after the show.
Yeah.
That's right. That's right. Although the minivan that pulled up had the Mickey antenna topper on it, so I'm like, okay.
Oh, well.
I go to their house. They've got their Disneyland caricatures on the wall. The mom's wearing her Mickey Mouse pajamas.
What?
I think it's okay. I think they're okay.
Man. See?
I'll be the judge of, you know, the mom's okay. I don't know about him yet.
Yeah. All right. Are we ready for the news?
Okay. Yeah, we'll go into the news. Okay. Let me come over here, back over to my, where's my list here? Okay, here we go. 3, 2, 1. And welcome back, everybody. And now it's time for our Disney news segment. So,
Gorg, and now it's time for Disney news.
And that was dangerous too, Chris, when I made that fall. So, don't you make fun of that. So we're going to go straight to Heather. And Heather, what's happening at Disneyland?
Lots is happening at Disneyland, although I did feel greedy because we've had the grand opening of Buena Vista Street, the grand opening of Cars Land, the reopening of the Matterhorn, the Carthay Circle restaurant has opened, and several other new places. Starbucks has come. So I'm standing there, and I'm like, but wait, what about Halloween? And then I feel like totally greedy because here I've got this whole brand new beautiful park, and then I'm worried about Halloween. Nevertheless, obviously I wasn't the only person because that day I opened up the Disney blog and saw that Mickey's Halloween party ticket dates, they were going to go on sale starting on July 9th for annual pass holders, and then they'll be for sale for the general public on the 16th. It didn't say how much the tickets were going to be. Usually there's a couple of nights that they'll have that are less expensive. My favorite night to always go is the first night because they're still kind of on shakedown and they're still like trying new things and it's early in the season, so there's not as many people. So that's a lot of fun. Disney for the parks in California is doing some different things to give people some extra magic time in the parks. Please go to the Disney Parks blog and check out Aaron Glover's post on June 20th. It talks about extra magic hour tickets. It talks about the Southern California City Pass tickets. It talks about how you can register as an annual pass holder to get into the park an hour early. It's more than just how I used to say, if you stay on property, you get in early, an hour early on days that begin with a T and an S. They've really ramped it up. They're trying to get people a little bit more time. at Disneyland and Disney California Adventure, they only open the park an hour early. They don't have, like, crazy extra magic hours at night like they do in Florida. You know, you can't be in the park until, you know, 4 o'clock in the morning or anything like that at Disneyland. The longest the park hours are usually for regular guests is 8 a.m. until midnight, and Main Street for your shopping convenience is open until 1. But that's it. So being able to get in at 7, that does allow you a little bit, another extra hour to do things. And then on those days that they have that, select attractions are open. Not the whole park is open. There are select attractions that are open. So please...
Hours here.
Pardon?
It's like extra magic hours here.
Yeah. Right, select attractions. So, but please check out Erin's post on June 20th on the Disney Parks blog, because she explains all of that. Your hotel, annual pass, and all the different type of tickets. And so Halloween, I'm so excited, is coming. And then also what's happening too next year, D23 Expo, last time in California for a few years. Tickets go on sale August 9th this year for the Expo, August 9th through the 11th of next year. So, and if you remember right from last time, if you bought your tickets early, you did get a discount. So we'll be buying our tickets soon for that. If you're planning a trip, the calendar at Disneyland goes through my birthday, August 12th. So feel free to check the hours, but usually it's, you know, 8 to midnight at Disneyland, 8 to 11 at Disney California Adventure. And the Carthay Circle Restaurant has a dining program that you can use to enjoy World of Color. So you don't have to eat at Ariel or the Trotteria. You can also dine at the Carthay Circle Theater restaurant in there, which was amazing, phenomenal. Loved it, loved it, loved it. It was just beautiful. Let's see what else. And then I was able to go to one of the new things. I'll have Hannah hit the lights for us. And we were able to do an annual pass holder event where we had to register in person. We couldn't just go online. Hit the lights, baby. And we got to do the glow with the show.
That
is so cool. We were there, and they had, for World of Color, we as an annual pass holder, we all got in this huge line that stretched almost the whole park, and we were given these ears. And we all stood out there waiting for World of Color to begin, and everybody's ears went blank. So we're all standing there, they're all blinking, and then they go blank. And then the Imagineer at the park controls them, and they are synchronized with World of Color. And so, like, my ears might be red, the next person might be green, somebody else may be blue, and then they would twinkle them. It was just amazing. And I'm, like, thinking, if they could employ this technology with the fireworks or the parades or some of the other stuff, it was just amazing. But we were kind of joking that, you know, after we did this, that Disney, like, got in our little brain, you know, because they do control them. I mean, it was funny. Everybody's, like, standing there, and then we're like, I now have this urge to add more DVC points. Or, oh, I now must book an extended trip. Or, yes, college program, here I come. So, but it was a lot of fun, and it was great. And this was one of the exciting things. And what was the neatest thing about it, though, is I know that I'll never be standing down there ever again with everybody wearing these ears. So that was pretty cool. It was at 11:45 on Friday night. So it was after the park, and they had to get everybody out, and we all had to have wristbands and everything. But it was great. So if you get a chance, buy the Glow with the Show ears and let the Imagineers there at the park control your ears. So, that's but yeah, awesome. That's everything that's kind of going on right now. I mean, they're getting excited and ready for Halloween. 4th of July is next week. They'll have special fireworks for the 4th. If you do go on the 4th, go early, get your hands stamped, and come back early if you leave the park, because the park will fill. So anyway, that's all I have for now.
And that is pretty exciting stuff they had happening out in California. I was watching that on Twitter myself to keep up. And now we want to go to Mr. Ireland. If you've been
Hello, everybody. How are you doing today?
What's happening in Disney World, Mr. Ireland?
Oh, well, in Disney World, there's a whole lot of stuff going on. Specifically, okay. So right over here, We've got some big stuff still going on over here. The end of the safari is continually changing still. It's getting to where hopefully in the next 4 or 5, maybe hopefully by, I think maybe October, November, we should have zebras on show. So that'd be cool. And it'd be really nice to have that. But yeah, so if you come to the safari, expect some construction, a lot of construction at the end. That's, we have 4th of July coming up at big fireworks at Animal Kingdom, not Animal Kingdom, big fireworks at Studios and Magic Kingdom and at Epcot. So 3 out of the 4 parks will have fireworks. They are, you know, things are going on. Fantasyland, new Fantasyland is looking awesome still, you know, lots of construction. But they just came out with the, you can check out the Disney Parks blog because they just showed the menu for the Be Our Guest restaurant, which Heather definitely needs to check out because there's lots of options for our friends who either because of a, because they either have celiac or because they choose to live gluten-free, there are options for them. So Heather would be very happy. Also, like Keith.
When does it open, Chris?
Fall.
Okay. All right. No, that's cool. Fall.
Yeah. So you know, it's all opening up in different, you know, it's opening up in sections. But really, it's really cool because if you actually go, and this was at the D23 Expo, I think last year. But if you actually go to one of my favorite things at Hollywood Studios, which is One Man's Dream, you can see the actual layout of what New Fantasyland is going to look like. Now, Dumbo, the really cool interactive queue, is, you know, is around, and kind of have to check that out because it's really cool. And I love, you know, when they brought Dumbo over to Storybook Circus, what they did there with you know, having it. You know, having a water feature to it, so it's kind of like Disneyland. It's got Fast Pass too. Yeah, it's got Fast Pass.
Fast Pass.
Yeah. And they have there's something really cool with the interactive queue where you can actually get a pager. You get a pager, and you can hang out in the interactive queue, and then they'll page you when it's your time to ride Dumbo.
Huh.
So that's something really cool. We actually just had a really exciting birth at Animal Kingdom. At the safari, a baby okapi was born.
Oh, I saw the pictures.
And if you're, you know, you can check it out. And also, if you're friends with me on Facebook, there, I posted a picture of that on there. But the baby okapi, it's really cute. I actually have a picture. Maybe no, I don't have the picture on my phone. But it's really cute because the body is like one size, and the head is pretty much the size of an actual okapi, in my opinion. It actually looks like it's not, the head's not going to grow. But it's really cool.
See if I can find one.
Yeah. But it's really cute. And hopefully we'll have, you know, we had a baby white rhino born a little while ago.
Really?
Hopefully that'll be out on safari eventually. We're looking maybe at the end of the month, end of July, I'm hoping. But it's really cool, you know. And of course, you know, there's always stuff going on here. Hopefully, you know, I can't wait for Test Track to be reopened again. Because it's real, because I think the racers at in Cars Land, they're modeled similar to
ish
modeled
kind of ish.
It's kind of like, yeah, you know,
it's kind of ish.
Kind of ish,
but kinda. Yeah, kind of ish.
Oh yeah, there it is, Keith. There's the baby okapi right there.
Yeah, isn't that cute? It's so cute.
But look at the head. It kind of looks, you know, it doesn't really look
I'm
like
I'm just glad I didn't give birth to that.
Or else I would be, you know, I'm sure Hannah's happy you're not the sibling to a Onokapi.
Yeah.
So let's just say that exciting stuff is always going on, but, you know, the biggest thing that's, you know, is continually going on is the Fantasyland expansion. So Casey Jr., the water little part, it opened a little while ago, the water experience. So a lot of, you know, storybooks, you know, a lot, blah, blah, blah. Storybook Circus is really coming along, and everything else at Magic Kingdom looks great. So
Yeah, I heard they were having some problem with Casey Jr. because of all the people letting their kids run around taking their clothes off.
Yeah, they're starting to come down on that. You know, the kids have to at least be clothed. You can't run around in a diaper.
Yeah. No, seriously, Heather, the parents are letting some of those kids.
I'm biting my tongue. I saw other people's children all week. You know, the thing I don't understand, it's like this week, normally we'll see a lot of skin because it's usually hot. What is the deal with letting your cheeks hang out your shorts? I saw cheeks, young, old, big.
No, I do not want to see old or big. I don't want to see old or big cheeks.
What? You don't want to see my cheeks?
I was like, what is the deal?
Frank, if you ever wear shorts short enough to where your cheeks hang out.
My kid even like mentioned it. She says, Mom, what's the deal? She even made like a tweet. Like, if I see one more pair of cheeks, I'm going to freak. I don't know. I mean, some of those rides are kind of hot, too. I mean, you sit down. It's a little warm, like, you know, sitting on the benches.
You don't want to wear short shorts if you're riding the safari because those seats, not that I know from personal experience, but those seats are like, what?
They're hot. Shorts, I don't know. It was just too. And it wasn't these cheeks. I just saw too many cheeks this last week. So I don't know what the big fashion trend is. I mean, I even saw people with jeans where they had a cutout so you could see their cheeks.
Frank, if you ever do that or ever wear shorts small enough to where your cheeks hang out, I will cut you. I will cut you.
He'll pull out his lightsaber.
I will pull out Vinylmations and cut you with a plastic.
I mean, it was like, you know.
And I will take this one. And
I was afraid people were going to make fun of me because I had on red Toms like everybody else in the park. But no, everybody was like, what's up with the cheeks? I even heard young people talk about the cheeks. So I don't know what the fashion thing is on the West Coast about the cheeks.
What's the deal with cheeks? I mean, come on. I mean, what are they doing? That was a really bad Jerry Seinfeld. Sorry.
You know, I don't know. It's even here in the Midwest. Right now, it's 101 here in the Midwest, and we're having some really ugly weather here. And you know, it's I still wear my stuff that I would wear to Walt Disney World outside. I just don't wear that stuff. But man, there are people that will get out there and wear anything they want.
You know, it's interesting that I think. Well, I see it in the parks all the time, but you know. It's interesting to me that I heard the temperatures in Florida and Orlando the last couple of days have been cooler than a lot of other places.
Well, it's been 111, 115 here. So we've already unfortunately had a handful of 115 plus degree days here. So I don't know, really, do 3 inches of fabric make a difference? I mean, are you really that much cooler?
No.
But I mean, you guys know I'm a girly girl. I 96% of the time have a dress or a skirt on. The only time you'll ever catch me in pants is in a Disney park on a cold day.
That's true.
I don't know.
Denny's,
I mean, I was like, am I getting too old? Is it like, get off my lawn?
Denny says she saw bikini
women. Get off my lawn, man. What are you doing on my lawn? Are you Hispanic now? Get off my lawn.
Hey, I do live in Arizona.
That's true.
Denny says she saw bikinis out in her way, and
you're in Canada. It's always freezing up there. How are people wearing bikinis in Canada? The temperature doesn't get above 50 degrees Fahrenheit.
She saw bikinis today.
Those are great pictures, Keith.
Dunk.
Oh yes, thank you. Yeah. Yeah, so it's really cool. The photos from the cars, thank you. I was going to mention that, but I appreciate it. But no, and then Lion King opens up in July, I believe. So, because they've been doing one opening for each month.
I can't see your face. I can only see, I can't see your mouth.
You complain way too much about seeing my face. Are you happy now?
Here. Yes, I am.
Here's my face. This is my face.
I'm ecstatic. I'm so excited now. I get to see what you look like.
I feel like I'm going to cut somebody today. And if I do, I'm going to have to talk like this. I am going to cut people. Don't mess with me. I got CDs around. I will cut you with it.
All right, all right, all right, all right, all right. It's not family friendly.
So.
By that, I mean I love each and every one of you.
I told you guys, I am the Rob. I am the Rob.
Please spread magic and pixie dust everywhere.
All right, well, let us go from talking about our dysfunctional Disney attractions to, hey, what do we need when we travel? Disney Bigsis is taking a little drink to be ready for this.
Disney. My travel tip is, for a lot of people who travel by car, and some people have bigger families, and I was talking about this with somebody. It was, in fact, I ended up tweeting it out yesterday. When we go on a road trip, everybody in my family has a job. Somebody's in charge of a certain part of the trip. So Hannah is always in charge of food and beverage. That's my daughter. She's always in charge of food and beverage. She's always in charge of the snacks. She actually makes a list of all the food and things that we need to get. And she arranges a time for us to go shopping and to pick up these items. So she's in charge of that. Because with the food allergies, we tend to eat a lot of food in the room and things on the road, because when we're traveling, if we drive just straight through, it's 6 hours. But if you need to, we need to stop and get gas and take care of a few other things, it can take us, 7 hours or so to get there. And in the meantime, we're going to get hungry and we can't just stop and eat. So she's in charge of making sure that all of the food and beverage is all together. And then my mom, she's the DJ. She's in charge of the music. On the way to Disneyland, we listen to Disney music only, and we have several CDs that just contain Disney music. We've got the musical history of Disneyland, which is 5 CDs long. We've got the parks music. We've got the four parks, one world music. We, at one point in time on Twitter, Disney music had done the 50 days of Disney's. So for every day for 50 days, they gave us a song. I missed the last 3 because we were on our trip one time. But so we have lots of music. So my mom's in charge of the music, and then I'm always in charge of transportation. So my job is, if we are taking our vehicles, to get them all checked up and everything. But it is really nice to be able to spread that out throughout the family. So that would be my travel tip, is if you haven't tried doing that, if your kids are older, try putting them in charge of something. The first time we put my daughter in charge of food and beverage, she learned a couple of lessons. She realized that she didn't bring some of the things that she thought that she would, and then she kind of had to do without. And so did everybody else. So not only was she back there hungry and grumbling, she had to hear the rest of us hungry and grumbling. So we haven't had that issue. My mom knows before we roll out the driveway that she's supposed to have her CD case. And for me, my job, if we're taking our cars, is to get the tires rotated or to get the car serviced or to deal with the rental car company. And then when my husband comes, and if we do something else, he's in charge of getting the directions to and from other places. So work together as a family to try and put things together. And it's interesting because it will challenge your communication skills with one another. And we've had some of our better conversations with that. So that's all I was just going to say. Just give everybody a job when we're traveling. I mean, my husband, when it comes to packing, he's like, as long as he's got enough underwear, he's good. So, but, if you don't bring enough shirts, right, you're at Disney. Right. You can buy another T-shirt. And right. Now, if your shoes break, you can go in and buy a pair of, at Disneyland anyway, they have the Sanuk shoe store, so you can go there and buy another pair of shoes. And in California, if I forget something, for me, I can run into Sephora. But it's just kind of like put your family in charge of other things, and not only does it help them with their responsibility, but it's also fun. It can spark some fun conversations. So that's my travel tip.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much. And before we get into our third segment, which will be a lengthier one because we have Chris coming up on. Chris is going to talk about his view of the world.
Are you calling me long-winded?
Yes, I am. I love you, Chris. I just want to share. I want to share some things that I actually got.
Vacation land.
This is my my vacation land from when the year I was born, and this is. There's Alice. This is from 1964.
Look at that monorail.
Yeah, there's a monorail behind there. There's Alice and the White Rabbit, and they're going to ride Alice in Wonderland ride. There's a guy dressed up as Pinocchio over here selling balloons, and a monorail behind him. And I'm not sure where this is at the Disneyland. Yeah. So I was born in 64. This is summer 64. Vacationland magazine. It's not titled for Disneyland. It's Vacationland.
Mm-hmm.
And my wife got that framed for me, and I have this picture that I got last year when Tony Anselmo was in town with Brett.
Nice!
Brett, with the... So Tony Anselmo, who's the voice of Donald, I got this picture at an auction there, and so he signed it as himself and Donald. And then I have this picture, which will... this one will go into our bathroom here downstairs next to our Disney room. And this is my Disneyland, Euro Disneyland stock certificate.
Wow.
Oh, wow. Very cool.
Because, that's before I was even Disneyland Paris.
Yeah. This is from 19... Oh, gosh. I have to look this thing all over again, but this is an early early one. So anyway, I just wanted to share these really quick. That these were three things my wife got framed for me. I've still got plenty more stuff to get framed, but that was part of my birthday. So we're gonna put these up. So we'll be right back, and in our last segment, we will hear from Chris and his view of the world, and then we'll do Mouse to Peace Theater.
Long-winded, hey, really?
Chris, yeah. I told the guys I only have until 7:20.
Okay, I won't be long-winded. You think I'm long-winded, too?
No, we're just kidding with you.
No, I'm just letting you know. No. Aww.
There's an extra one.
Wow.
You didn't care.
Wow.
We need to give away a prize too. We forgot all about that. I'm sorry.
We give away a prize. The prize will be me again.
Oh, I have a sweet friend here in Arizona. He's looking for his Disney princess. He's newly single, 34 to 44, and must be a Disney lover.
There you go. Because he doesn't win any fights over travel.
That's right.
I don't want a full-size monorail in my bag. Oh, wait, I have one. Never mind.
Yeah, no, just really sweet, sweet guy.
No, but I have a good friend that does.
Really? Really? As your job or, like, as a treat? Very good. Wow. Yeah. How cool is that?
Yeah, how many companies can you win?
I've got
to drive a lot of boats. What boats have you driven, Keith? Have you gotten to steer the Grand One? Have you gotten to drive up? Okay, there we go. I got to steer the Grand One.
Yeah. Okay, I've got a good question. Here we go. So we'll come back. We'll do a question for a giveaway prize, and then we'll let Chris do his view of the world. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Welcome back, and now we're going to give away a mouse surplus prize, and the question. The question today is Epcot. I want to know what was not sold inside Epcot when the park first opened.
Oh, that's easy.
Okay. Well, don't say the answer. Is it A, alcohol, B, beverages in plastic cups, which were deemed environmentally unfriendly, C, balloons, or D, Disney character merchandise. What was not sold inside Epcot when the park first opened? Alcohol, beverages and plastic cups, balloons, or Disney character merchandise? Let's see. Alcohol. No, alcohol is not the right answer. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Oh, 80, 90, 90.
After you get the answer, I have a little thing to say.
I know the answer.
I
know everything about Epcot because it opened 18 days before I was born. Yep, I'm going to be 30 this year.
I'm not going to say anything else until the person puts the right answer. There's four choices.
Someone said balloon.
Actually, three. And I still haven't said the right one.
Balloons and alcohol. Plastic cups.
No.
Character merchandise.
Character merchandise is correct.
Duncan
won. It says, in an attempt to keep the park separate and distinct from one another, no Disney character merchandise was sold in Epcot when it opened. In fact, after Mickey Mouse showed up for the park's grand opening in 1982, he was not seen or heard again for 2 years.
True. Hey, I have something to show you guys, too. I got to see this by the hand of Dave Smith last Sunday. This is the first ticket for Epcot. It's ticket number one, Epcot ticket. There you go. You can see it's the Epcot. And down there, if it'll focus, you will see that it is ticket number one.
I want it.
It was so cool to see Dave Smith. Oh, and you know how they also talk about, okay, here's the first ticket for Walt Disney World Magic Kingdom. That's ticket number one for there. And you know how they always talk about how Roy bought ticket number one for Disneyland? Well, that they don't have that right now because they're getting ready for this big display at the Ronald Reagan National Library for D23 for an archive exhibit. Wow. So he had something that is even more elusive than parking than ticket number one. He actually has one of the parking passes that you got, and it was gummy on one side, so you would have licked it and stuck it on your car windshield. So there is the elusive parking pass from Disneyland Grand Opening Day. It was so cool. I'll have to talk about the Disney Studios another time, but there you go. Just a little bit of trivia.
And now it's time to hear from our friend Chris_Topher and his view of the world.
Well, Jumbo, everyone, and welcome to Kilimanjaro. I'm just kidding. Jumbo, everyone, welcome to my view of the world. Jumbo means hello in Swahili, so Jumbo. My view of the world is pretty chaotic right now. Lots of cool stuff going on, but it's pretty chaotic. I've got a couple performances coming up in the next couple of weeks with Encore, which is a Disney cast member performance group. And we're doing our show this year, which is called Finding Wonderland. It's a big thing of the last 10 years of the shows that they've done. So it's really exciting. And then also I've got some big things going on in October and November, which are going to be a little crazy for me, but you know, I'm doing a couple shows out in the community. So it's really happy for me because I'm acting again out in the community, which makes me happy. So it's exciting. I'm excited to be out in the community doing theater again, which it's been a while since I've done that. You found Denny Wonderland, Keith. Where will I be doing karaoke? Where do I not do karaoke? Oh, I got to show this real quick. Okay, ready for this? Do you know what this is?
That looks like an old...
You getting off script?
Yes.
It looks like that's an old map.
It's an old park map where you just showed
awesome.
It. Awesome. Yeah. It's awesome. Okay, so where am I going to be doing karaoke? Well, it depends on the day of the week. Wednesdays, you can find me at Devaney's Irish Pub. Thursdays you can find. It's true. I love doing karaoke. I love singing. I love LAMP as well. Well, that's what you know. That's why you do candlelight every year, because it helps, you know, you get to do that. So you know, life is good. Life is really good right now. I can say that life can't get any better. But I know if I say that, life will get better. So you know, my view of the world's always pretty optimistic, just because I live in a weird world. Let's just say that my world is not like a lot of other people's worlds. And I think it's something I take for granted sometimes, but it's true. It's not like a lot of other people's worlds. How many people can say that they live in, they live 5 minutes away from magic and awesomeness, and they get, well, besides Keith. But, you know, I get to share, I get to do, you know, things for guests every day that, I get to do things for guests every day. You know, there's people that come out with their families, and one of my favorite things that I get to do is at safaris, we have what are called Departure 3 trucks or wheelchair accessible trucks, and we have 8 of them. And I like working Departure 3 or working or driving the trucks there, because a lot of times you have families who they can't do a lot of the other rides together because they have a family member who is either permanently in a wheelchair and they can't move other places, or it's a little too rough for them. I actually had a family a couple weeks ago that was the first time that they all got to ride together on a ride ever.
Wow.
And so it's one of those things for me that is just, you know, it's one of those moments that you never know what you're going to encounter every day. You never know who you're going to encounter or what you do. But it's one of those special things that, you know, I was told by a family, this is the first time my son has ever got to ride with his father on the ride, because this father was in a wheelchair and he can't ride a lot of the rides because they're even some of the wheelchair accessible rides for different reasons. So, you know, this is the first time they ever got to ride together, and you could just see the tears streaming down the dad's face. And it was one of those things that, for me, is just one of those moments in my life. It's like the time that I got to sit and watch Wishes with the family whose daughter was a Make-A-Wish child, and she sings the Wishes song. And I got to sit and watch Wishes with them. It's one of those experiences in your life that you don't forget, and I don't ever want to take those things for granted, knowing that I have a very rare opportunity in my life right now to help change people's lives and to help make people's lives. You know, a lot of these people are coming to the parks for the first time. This is the first and only time they'll ever get to come to the parks. Mm-hmm. For me, I think there are days when I have really bad days at work and I just want to say, you know, forget it all. But then there's the days like I had a couple weeks ago that I missed. You know, that I just get to help people's lives. And I had another experience. It was actually one of the days where I saw Glenn in Magic Kingdom, where, I don't know, I think I've told this story before, but when I was working, I think I have told the story, but I'm going to tell it again, because it was one of those times when you don't know what's going on with people in their lives, but it was one of the days where it was raining and they actually canceled. Magic Kingdom will rarely ever cancel a parade. You know, they have other options for parades, but they'll never, unless it's torrential downpour. So there were bands. Usually we have high school bands during the months of March and April that will come in and perform. But we had this one band, and this wife was waiting for her husband, who was a band director. And she had a balloon for him, which is the color of the high school, and it was a green balloon. And she was standing in the street, and we can't have anyone standing in the streets during that. So I had to, and she told me, she's like, is there any way that I can give this to my husband? She's like, I was actually not supposed to be here, because earlier in the week she had a heart attack and was in the hospital and wasn't even expected to live. And at the end of the week, she's sitting there with her able to see her husband and his band
perform at Magic Kingdom. And I got to escort her over to give her husband the balloon and then walk back with her. And at the end, I got a picture with her. And, you know, she wanted a picture with me. And it was just, it's one of those things where, you know, you never know people and their lives and what they're going to do. But I don't think I'll ever take what I do for granted. I can't. Because in my life, I get to help people's lives, you know, bring magic to people and bring happiness to people. And it is, it's an amazing experience. And, you know, yeah, in the next couple of months, my view of the world's going to get a pretty chaotic. I'm doing two shows in the community and with work and other things like that, working full time, doing two shows at the same time. But I just remind myself every day about these stories and the people that come here and the guests that I interact with and that make my job easier. So thank you all out there who come to the parks, who
Hold on.
Back to that. I'm crying.
So yeah.
So thank you to the guests who come in, who come to the parks, who help change us as cast members, who help change our lives, and who make things memorable for us, because it's because of you that we do what we do. Because it's because of you that we are here. So, thank you. And so I'm going to leave you all with a Swahili phrase that means go well. And that phrase is kwaherini. So kwaherini, everyone. Go well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay. That was, sorry.
That was just right on the money. I mean, you just and we're all like sitting here just waiting for you to get to the end, and it just stopped. We all freaked out.
Sorry.
You could have a fun hangout where everybody just freezes at the same time and just screws with the audience.
Frank, are you ready for Masterpiece Theater? Because I know Heather has to go soon.
Yeah, let me get my Gmail up here. And
let me get my Gmail up.
And what we're going to do is we're going to do a little Masterpiece Theater.
Hello, Gmail, ¿dónde estás?
I've got the little rainbow circle thing going on.
Oh, the little spinny wheel.
It's on Frank's nose right now. It makes him look like
a beach ball. Yeah, I saw Brave today. That was awesome. I like the very end.
It's a good mother-daughter movie. That's all I'm saying.
Hello, mother. Hello, father. Oh, he saw it for free. Okay.
All right, so, I'm going to have to pull it up on my phone. Sorry.
All right. So on tonight's Masterpiece Theater, as Chris is trying to bring his up, we are going to do a scene from Airplane 2. And it's the terminal scene. Bud Krueger, head of the Space Center, and the commissioner get out of a limo under a sign that reads Mercury Shuttle, and they walk and talk
Heather.
Heather.
Hello, Heather. Where are you? Are Kermit the Frog here? Ha ha ha. Okay, I'm warming up.
Hey, who, Kermit the Frog here? No.
Hopefully, Heather gets back in here.
Hey, old Kermit the Frog here.
Why are there so many songs about rainbows and what's on the other side? Okay, I'm good.
Did you find it?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm ready whenever you are.
So Kermit is Kruger and Mickey. Oh gosh! Mickey is the commissioner. And Kruger is going to start us out. Go ahead, Kruger.
Commissioner, we both know the Mercury shuttle needs another month of pre-launch testing.
Ah, well, forget. The boys on the board want that shuttle to go on schedule.
And what do the boys on the board know about safety, Commissioner? Let me talk to them, because safety begins with me.
Well, Bud, get wise to the politics realities. The boys on the board are under a lot of pressure from the boys downtown, by golly.
And I'll be the one they'll hang if there's a screw-up.
Oh, gosh, listen, Bud. The boys downtown are under heavy fire from the boys in Washington. That's why they're putting pressure on the boys on the board.
Well, you tell the boys on the board to tell the boys downtown to let the boys in Washington know that the press has been nosing around to my people in the front office.
You handle your front office people. I'll handle the press and lead the boys in Washington to the boys downtown and the boys downtown to the boys on the board.
Commissioner?
What?
I just wish it was that simple.
And scene.
Shortest scene we have ever done.
Is that the shortest one we've ever done?
Yes.
Well, that seemed like an interesting scene. And, well, Glenn says we did a nice job. He liked it.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Oh, gosh.
Well, we did. I never got anything back from.
I did.
From Anthony, did you hear from Heather?
Yeah, she says she's restarting her computer and don't talk about her while she's gone. Let's talk about Heather, guys.
anybody want to say anything about Heather while she's trying to get back on here so that we can say goodbye?
She's the Rob.
What's the Rob?
I have no idea.
She talked about that earlier. She's the Rob. Heather is awesome, Denny says.
She is the person, she's the glue that holds us together. We've had a show without her, and it was mass chaos and convulsion.
This is true. She keeps us sane. She keeps us from going overboard.
Mm-hmm.
Well, and you said she's trying to come back on here? Because all we're doing is rambling until we...
And you lost Chris, too.
Now we lost Chris. I'm gonna say goodbye. I'm going to say goodbye before I lose Keith. I wish to thank our guests today, Heather and Chris.
And me.
And Keith for being part of Mr. Frank's Wild Ride. No, I tell you what, guys. You guys hang out. We'll get everybody on. We will do a non-broadcast version of the gathering. I want to thank Heather and Chris very much for being part, and they've been with me for a very long time, so it's really cool. And thank you, Keith. We appreciate you very much, Disney Keith, and how else are you known online, Disney Keith? Right.
And Google Plus Hangouts. KeithBarrett.com is where my blog is, and I'm all over Google Plus and Twitter and Facebook is Keith Barrett.
So you can follow us at Mr. Frank's Wild WLD Ride. You can follow us at Disney Frankness, at Disney Big Sis, at Chris, there's Chris _ Topher, Toffer. That's all three of us. We appreciate everybody watching. Be part of our group on Facebook. Just look at Mr. Frank's Wild Ride, and we'll be happy to share what we're doing. So again, thank you very much. You guys in the chat room, hang out, and we will invite you into our into hanging out with us after the show. So until then, take care, be kind one another, spread a little Disney magic where you can. Good night.
All right, so I am back, everybody, and I am going to join Frank's Hangout as soon as I see an invite for it. Actually, he didn't make it clear whether I was starting this Hangout or he. I'm going to assume it's he, because it doesn't really matter who starts the Hangout. Frank, if I'm wrong, say so in the chat room. And while we're waiting, I will get the... Ooh, I gotta stop the recording. I'm still recording. Hold on.